So just a quick video, Josh. Like with my case, for my airflow, I've got three fans here in the front and they draw air into the front over my hard drives. My hard drives can get warm, especially if they're working in the array, but they just produce heat. And now I've got two video cards, 1080 Ti's. They're heat monsters, but they are what they call the reference series. And they actually have a high-speed blower, so they're loud, that draws in the bottom and then expels the heat in the back out of the case. So I have fresh air come in, and then it draws back out through the video cards out the back. And then I've got, it's kind of hard to see, but this is my triple rad AIO up top. These draw air in, then I've got the rad here, and then I have another set of fans. So these exhaust the heat here. So I have exhaust out the back, out the video cards, you know, out the power supply, everything out the back there, exhaust out the top. All the bottom is just open air with a big filter, and then my front is also open air, but it has those fans to push air over the hard drives. So I have a major airflow through my case and it works really well. And it just, the advantage of the AIO is it does take some of the heat away from around the board, and I get great airflow now because nothing's around my memory, right? It just draws the air up over my memory. My memory stays cool when I crank on it too. So it all just kind of, when you're doing it, you just kind of got to think about the design and how your airflow is going to go. That CPU will produce a ton of heat if you're pushing it, and as long as you can eject it and then have a way to eject the heat out of the the GPU too, because it's also a heat monster. Like, as long as you can get that air out and get fresh air in, you're fine. It's just a matter of how you want to do it.